Hi there, I'm Chihiro from Japan. Welcome back to the program. Let's learn a life lesson from a story together. There are many emotions in human beings. Among those, the one which is hard to control is anger. Losing control of anger can lead to losing jobs, breaking up with partners, and doing something wrong to regret in life. So, what is the cause of anger? Don't you think that life would be easier if you could control your anger? Today, I would like to talk about anger. Anger can ruin relationships that you have built up with others. You may say words you shouldn't say or take actions you shouldn't take. Anger hurts both people around you and yourself. Then, should we suppress anger no matter what happens? Should we aim to be someone who never gets angry? That would make our minds tired from stress. Buddha has talked about how to live with anger in a calm and healthy way. Thanks for subscribing to my channel. Let's get started then. Where does anger come from? What is the cause of anger? Before considering that, let me tell you something important. Buddha said, "Be careful when you think you're right." That's very good advice. When you think, "I'm not wrong," you easily get angry. Despite you following the rules properly, others broke the rules. Don't you get angry in such a situation? There can be disputes over the he said, she said argument. You thought you said it, but the other person says they didn't hear it. There also can be a situation in which the other person says they told you, but you don't remember it at all. We often argue about those things afterward, don't we? There are many such situations in the world. But we are all human beings. You are not always right, of course, and neither are the other people. We tend to think that we are doing the right thing, but let's take a moment to calm down and think about it. Humans make mistakes. That's right. Humans make so many mistakes. What you think is right can be your own bias. There's no need to make things black and white. If we think that way, don't you think we could get along better with others? It's not when we are right and not making mistakes that we get angry. It's when we believe we are right and become conceited that we get angry. Imagine yourself assuming you're not making any mistakes. When we think about it calmly like this, don't you feel ashamed? First of all, let's re-examine ourselves. There are other causes of anger. We get angry when our desires are obstructed. For example, if someone pointed out your flaws in front of many people, how would you feel? You'll feel ashamed. They didn't need to say it in front of everyone. When you think like that, anger wells up, doesn't it? Then, how do you react when you're alone with someone and the person tells you, you have this flaw, so you should improve, you might be able to accept it. There may even be the feeling of gratitude for telling you honestly. If someone points out your flaws in public, it doesn't matter if it's true or not. What matters is that you feel angry and embarrassed about being shamed in front of others. You may think that the person made fun of you and insulted you. In fact, this anger arises from being obstructed in your desires. Everyone has the desire to be well-liked by those around them. The desire for prestige was obstructed, and that's why anger arose. In the end, let's talk about anger towards people close to us. We see sad news on TV every day. When you see them, you may feel depressed, sympathetic, or angry. However, for you, that news is someone else's problem and it's something that is happening in the world inside the TV. So, let me ask you a question. Do you sometimes have arguments with your partner? How do you feel then? You don't get angry at your loved ones? Are you sure? Try to remember when you had a quarrel with your partner. Let's go back to the beginning. Think about your partner and the criminal who caused the sad case you've seen on TV. Who did the worst thing? Your partner or the criminal who caused an incident serious enough to be broadcast on TV? Without comparing, it's the criminal, right? But your anger towards your partner for hurting you was probably greater, right? That's right. The magnitude of anger doesn't depend on the severity of the offense. You would be in a rage because your partner is someone important to you. There's no such thing as rational anger. You get angry because someone is important to you. Because we cherish our partners, we use our time for them, and we devote our money, energy, and emotions to them. That's why we get angry with their remarks and say, "How would you say something like that?" Now, what should we do? The best solution is to forget. You might say, "I did all this for you. I did all that for you." The more you remember those things, the more it can lead you to anger. That's why Buddha says, "Forget about it." It leads you to peace of mind. Additionally, if someone expresses anger towards you, it may be because they care about you. Understanding the cause of their anger can help you to calm your mind. However, if their anger becomes excessive or if you're constantly arguing with them, it's better to distance yourself from those people. Please keep in mind that everything I've been talking about so far is about the arguments that can sometimes occur between people who love each other, Hopefully, this video is helpful to you. Well, that's about it for today's episode. How was it? I hope your life shines even brighter. Let's talk about life, time, Buddhism, love, and many other things together in the following episode. Please subscribe to our channel. Have a great time and keep on smiling. Thank you for listening till the end. See you soon.